Today we're going to do a tour of Legoland Windsor, UK of the full park in under 3 minutes. Links may pop up for more detailed information on attractions. We start at the Atlantis Submarine Voyage near the Castle Hotel on the far side of the park from the main entrance. On the screen you can see the names of the different attractions pop up as we go past them. The park has over 50 attractions, so you won't get through them in one day. Click the link for the top 10 rides and attractions that our kids really enjoy, and they're a good place to get started with your day. We recommend getting to the park at 9:30 in the morning when the turnstiles open. The actual park itself doesn't open till 10 o'clock. You might then wander in and wonder why there's a whole bunch of people already wandering around. People who stay at the Lego hotels are able to actually get a half hour start and actually start in the park at 9:30. We recommend picking out two of the more popular rides and heading straight for them as soon as you get in. We say two because more often than not, you get into the first ride and it's either not open or there's a technical delay or something like that. You don't want to be messing around trying to figure out which is the other ride you'd prefer to go to instead. Queues that can quite quickly blow out to 1 or 2 hours include the Haunted House, Ninjago, Lego City Driving School, Coast Guard, HQ Boats. QBot is Legoland Windsor's Fast Pass Fast Track ride reservation system. Click the link for a video explaining how QBot works, the pricing, and some quirks of the system. It can be an overly complicated system and you need to get your head around it, and once you do that, then you can really enjoy it and maximize the value of it. The thing to keep in mind is that the park is targeted for 3 to 12 year olds, so any teenagers might think it's beneath them or not cool enough for them. Anyone under 3 might not meet the height restrictions, but generally get to go for free anyhow. We've stayed a couple of times at the Legoland hotels and they're great fun, so certainly consider that. However, they do book out a fair bit in advance, so if there's a particular room style that you want to get, make sure you can book really, really early. Doing a multi-day stay is great because you don't feel that you're rushing around so much and trying to cram everything into one day. You can plan things out a bit better. One day you might get a QBot and try to do all the rides, and the next day you might try to do all the shows. Invariably, there might be a ride closed on one day that you want to do, but then the next day it's open and a different ride is closed. Make sure you check out Miniland, as it's great to see the different buildings and models that they come up with. It does have a European bias and a lot of buildings from the UK. However, they did recently add a USA section, and they're always adding little bits and tweaking and updating. Make sure you're wearing some comfortable shoes and be prepared for a fair bit of walking. On the day, on average, we usually walk about 10 km or 6 miles. Legoland Windsor is located 20 miles west of London, and you're generally going to need a car to get there. Allow plenty of time to get out of the car park. It is our least favourite aspect of Legoland, and something they seriously need to address. Hopefully that's given you a quick overview of the park, so you can have a great day.
If you want to feel great and help out two young filmmakers, please subscribe. It will greatly encourage us. Be sure to check out our other videos.